Right, Craig, nice to see you again. You lost to Lee Purdy in the last fight, losing the British title. You know, after dominating the fight in the first five rounds, you know, what went wrong there?
Well, I just too much, too soon, really. One fight, obviously, in February with Old Donald, beat him. And then, obviously, the other fight, it was just a bit too soon, and just I put too much in myself, and, you know, when you, I'm the kind of person that when you offer me a fight, I'll jump at it with two hands, and and Joe knows what kind of person I am. Really, we should have both sat back and said, "Is this the best option to take this so quick?" And obviously, I paid the price, but I aim to get him back for that.
Run us through the fight. You know what?
Just beforehand, I remember warming up. I just couldn't get warm, and I've never been like in the changing rooms. I was like to Joe, I need more pads, because I just couldn't get warm in myself. I just couldn't get sharp and warm. So I just, anyway, I went through the motions, went outside, and kept us waiting for a bit, even longer. Got into the ring and I just wasn't warm. And anyway, I got in the fight. First five rounds, I was breezing through it. So easy, it'd been so comfortable, it was untrue. But just had no power in the shots, just no pop whatsoever. Just felt dead lethargic and dead weak. Anyway, got caught with a shot. I stepped over to the left, got caught with a shot. I was off balance a lot as well at the same time. I was crossing my legs because I was stepping over. And just got caught with one. It wasn't an hard shot. I was up in 3 seconds, really. I should have stayed down and took the count, but bravery and courage, just once you bounce right back up and carry on. And obviously the referee, obviously seeing my eyes was a bit glazy and waved the fight off, and I was gutted, really gutted, and just can't wait to get him back.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel caused that? Why was you so weak at the weight? You know, just back on it now.
No,
was
I mean,
it the weight issue, or was it?
Yeah,
it was
a bit of both. It was like I had one fight, like I said, we were against Donald Donald like 8 weeks before, and I should have had a month out, really, and then come back to the gym. Let my body rest because I trained long and hard for the Old Donald fight, and then it was just I had the weight down like 2 weeks beforehand. I was on the weight, and just I don't know. When I kept the weight down too soon, I mean, obviously I went in the ringer like near enough the fight I was weighing in at, you know. So this time I've kept a bit back, and I'm aiming to go in a lot heavier than I did last time.
So you could have overtrained or
overtrained. My body was just run down into the ground, and I didn't know until I got in the ring.
Right, it's probably worn down. And did Lee Purdy, you know, what did you think of his performance against you?
I think he's very flat-footed, and I honestly don't rate him as a fighter. I think he's tough, he's strong, but I don't rate his boxing skills. Mm-hmm. I think he's very flat-footed. He's very one-dimensional. And I can't wait to get in there with him now and show him what kind of fighter I am. He was lucky, really lucky to win the first time.
He was dominating the fight up until that point, wasn't he?
I made it look so easy. I mean, even my friends who was watching was like, turned away and having a laugh because they thought it was too easy. It was like, it was just boring for them. There was no excitement in it. Well, I want to make excitement this time. Mm.
And you lost your British title, which I know meant a lot to you.
Yeah, it meant an awful lot to me, and meant an awful lot to everyone that's around me. You know, everyone in the gym and all my family. And I remember, like, even afterwards, like, phoning me, just going back to the changing rooms and closing the door in the shower room and just crying my eyes out to my mum and dad. I can't wait to get him back now. I really can't.
Well, you've got that chance to make amends July 16th.
I've got to thank Ricky Hatton and everyone at Hatton Promotions. They've done me a massive, massive favour getting me this straight away. No TV. He's put a lot of his money and his time and his effort into it, all of them. And I've got to really thank them. And I mean, you can't fault them as promoters. You wouldn't see any other promoter in England doing this for any of their fighters. So for me to have a promotional company that's right behind me to do that and help me all the way, I'm so happy with, and I've got to thank them.
And getting you an immediate rematch is
exactly that's what I mean. The immediate rematch, home turf, no TV, but they're still willing to do it. I mean, it's what dreams are made of, and I'm so happy they've done it for me.
I suppose Purdy actually, you know, giving you that opportunity to win it back and come into your own serve. Was it in the contract?
It was in the contract. There's a clause in the contract, so he's pretty much asked to do it.
He's got to do it anyway. And what will you do different this time, learning from the last fight?
There's not much different that I need to work. There's obviously little things I need to work on, like head movement and stuff that I have worked on more. And obviously, just little aspects of training and just little things like movement and just little things I've worked on.
Different preparation.
Yeah, total different.
And mentally, how will you approach the fight?
Do you know what? I'm always mentally strong. Yeah, I don't believe in being weak. I believe in confidence. And I'm confident I'm going to beat him. And if I weren't confident, then you're going to lose. That's the way I am about confidence. I'm just so confident it's untrue.
Yeah. And I take it, you know, a loss to you is just, you know, you get up, you dust yourself down, you get back on, Some boxers put a lot of emphasis on it.
You see a football match, it's the skillful side against the not so skillful side. Some not so skillful side wins. Do you know what I mean? It's the same. He just caught me on an off day, and I aim to punish him for it.
And you're fighting in Oldham again, like you said, just finishing in front of your own fans. Well, that's going to be a big occasion.
Massive. Tickets are absolutely flying out. I've never had it so good. I mean, absolutely flying. I can't wait. Like I say, the posters are everywhere around all of them. And, even every single day, people are on my Facebook sending me messages, I need 10 tickets, I need 5 tickets, I need this many. It's going to be a sellout and it's going to be a proper, really good occasion. And brilliant for all of them. I mean, they don't really get much other than like the football and the rugby. And it's not a massive thing. They're not doing really well. So for me to win the British title in Oldham, being from Oldham, it's massive for Oldham itself.
You know, you recently went to an opening of a gym there, didn't you?
Yeah, I went to an opening of a gym. They're having a boxing show this Friday. I'm going to bob along there. And no one's defended a British title in Oldham for 15 years. For me to bring it round in 15 years is amazing. I'm really privileged to bring a British title to Oldham after 15 years.
Yeah, to get that British title back.
Yeah, win it back in my hometown. And obviously, for it to be 15 years, amazing.
Mm. Have you watched the Purdy fight back yet?
No, I won't watch it.
You not watch it?
No, yeah. I'm dead. A bit like I can't. Honest, I really can't. Mm. I don't want to see it. Mm. I just want to punish him for it. And I know what went on. It was in my head. It still goes round in my head every day. And every day I train like an absolute demon with that little thing at the back of my head. Mm. Knowing what he did to me last time, I'm going to punish him for it. Mm.
Good luck, Craig, with the fight.
Cheers,
anyway.
Thanks
for the interview. Great to see you.
Cheers. That's good.